Let us pray. O God, to whom mercy and forgiveness belong, hear our prayers on behalf of your mere servant, our seed, Leone, whom you have called out of this world, and because she put her hope and trust in you, command that she be carried safely home to heaven and come to enjoy your eternal reward. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seem, in the view of the foolish, to be dead, and their passing away was thought an affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction. But they are in peace. For if in the eyes of humanity indeed they be punished, yet is their hope full of immortality. Chastise a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace he proved them, and as sacrificial offerings he took them to himself. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with his elect. The word of the Lord.
Brothers and sisters, our citizenship is in heaven, and from it we also await a Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ. He will change our lowly body to him, to conform with his glorified body, by the power that enables him, also to bring all things into subjection to himself. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please do.
Lord of heaven and earth. For although you have hidden these things from the wise and the learned, you have revealed them to the childlike. Yes, Father, such has been your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father. No one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son wishes to reveal him. Come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you a rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart, and you will find rest for yourselves. For my yoke is easy, and my burden light. The Gospel of the Lord. Say that is a thing of joy, because most times many people do not cooperate with the grace of God in their lives. She cooperated with the grace of God, and that made her strong, faithful, loving, caring, standing by her husband all the way, maintaining the family business with all dedication. Even when the husband was gone, she kept faith. She was not discouraged, because she knew that God loved her. And that love she shared with everyone, especially those who cannot pay her back. Say thank you, was there to entertain even the prisoners, playing music. You see, this thing called the organ and music. I know why I respect all those who stand there. This is one of the things in the world that take discipline for you to learn. If you are not disciplined, you cannot be a musician. And she was there entertaining people, so versed in the song that she didn't play by the ear, just because she wanted to share her love. She didn't want her talent to waste. Neither did she use it selfishly. She was generous with what God gave her. And from what the family wrote, they say, she can do anything for anyone. Anything that will make you smile. Anything that will make you happy. She's ready to offer that. And that's a beautiful thing. We need to learn. And was there for her family. Even when the family was growing larger and larger and larger, she had a large heart to who took after more, as the most loved of chefs. And they told me two granddaughters who are doing good. I love it. Because being there, you know, being a chef is not an easy thing. If it's not something you love to do, you will see it as a burden. And she did that to create the joy in the home. And when we talk about the souls of the righteous being in the hands of God, this is where it comes in. Those who live righteous lives, those who held their faith strong in God, and also shared their love with other people, improving the lives of others, whoever they come in contact with. Be that person a member of the family, be that person a distant person, anybody in need. And doing that may not always be an enjoyable experience. You may see people doing certain things smiling. It may not be that joyful. The only joy is that they are doing it for God and to the glory of God. Many people walk away from such services because they find it too hard. And that's why the gospel really tells us, come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest. God never promised us that life will be all rosy. No. At some point, we meet the odds of life. It will be challenging. It can come through loss of job, disappointment from friends, death of a loved one. Never allow such situations to take you to depression. Know that Jesus is calling us in such situations to come to Him. He will give us that strength of soul, which, yes, the eyes may not see, but you are convinced of what you have. And being in a funeral service like this, it's always happy to hear that reading again, the second reading, where St. Paul was telling us, we are all citizens of heaven. That is the greatest thing you can have as a Christian. Without that, the beauty of Christianity is gone. And with that, Christians are proud. Because the beauty of Christianity is that not just that we have it good here, worshiping God, doing our best, but we are hopeful that after life, we also have it good. And that what keeps us going and going and going. And whenever we come at funerals, it's time to ask ourselves questions. How well are we doing? What story will we tell them about us when it is our turn? How many lives have you touched? How many people will tell the stories of their lives and mention your name as being instrumental? What sacrifices are you making for the happiness of others? How seriously are you taking your worship of God and your faith in Him? Are we part of the people who believe that everything is all about life here, as though heaven doesn't matter? And it's time like this reminds us that we all will walk away sometime, someday, somehow, some way. But the beautiful thing is that when we gather, we give ourselves examples. Everybody should have something you look up to. You should have a hero in your life. And the virtuous life of good people are what we're looking up to. So for the family, we are comforting you and consoling you achieve love. Many families don't have that. It's a rare privilege. So you should also be happy. And one thing you must do for mom, for your grandma, is to pick something from her life and add to your own life. Pick something from her life. And it must be something that will help you to worship your God better and to also touch lives. Life is not about selfishness. Because the reality of life goes against selfishness. From birth to life to death. We all exist because somebody showed us love when we are born. Your parents were not selfish. And we all are buried because somebody helps us of death. So it's not all about self, about you, me. No. Sometimes it's also about what you're leaving behind, how you're touching the lives. So as we thank God for the gift of this noble woman, we have to pray for her, assist her with prayers. Always, we are encouraged to pray for our dead. Because the journey from this life to the great beyond is not an easy one. And the assistance they get is prayer. Good enough, we're beginning with this Mass and with all the prayers we've been saying, but it goes beyond this. So that when she gets there, she will also return the favor. Praying for us, watching our backs, helping us. Because it's a privilege God gives to his saints. So whichever way, we don't lose by praying for them. So my dear friends, let's pray that our faith in God will continue to be strong. And that faith, surely, will never disappoint us. Because we are citizens of heaven. God bless you.
Strengthen our hope so that we believe in the Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray. Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer Jesus Christ and the voices of your people, whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb, especially your daughter Elsie Louise. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ and grant them a place in your kingdom. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Remember your maidservant Elsie Louise, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who was united with your son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph and spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever. Behold the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. We appreciate everyone who is here for this month with us, for the Eucharistics, for Catholics who are ready for it, who go around. So whenever the minister comes around, if you're a Catholic and you're ready for it, you bring out the camp service. finally, before we part, I wish to appreciate each and every one of you. It can never thank you enough. And you need to know that whenever you attend a funeral, you also gain grace. It is the greatest of all corporal works of mercy, because you are helping the most helpless. So I appreciate everyone here, especially you. I also appreciate the family for giving your mom and your grandma this honor of full Catholic funeral. It's a privilege not to deny their hope, but I am happy you were able to make sure that everything went good. I appreciate the coming funeral home for their services. Tony, for helping me. Tom, for looking at my face and making my face available. So thank you for being here. I'm happy to see you. I also thank the musicians, Nathan and Lois, for doing their work very well as always, and the hospitality ministers who have always been here to make sure you're safe. So one question for the family. I know I've asked some, but there was one I forgot to ask. I'm happy two of the granddaughters are now chefs. But what of this? Who got this? The music. For Elsie, and now we come to the last farewell. There is always sadness in part, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see her again and enjoy her friendship. Although this congregation will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of His kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ.
We give
dear Elsie Louise, this worshiping community bids you farewell. May the angels of God lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you.